Could I stop Wait, him? After we went to the gas station, so let's continue.
I don't know what you mean.
I mean, why do you still wear the cuts? You and Boozer, it's not like you're trying to recruit anymore or staking out territory.
No.
A couple of guys I worked with at the plant wore colors on the weekend. I asked them about it once, and they said they wore them as a way of saying, fuck you, to, I don't know, cops,
Whoops.
Authority, the government. So what are you rebelling against?
Whatever's left. Look, we wear them because we wear them. What do you want? I mean, no idea about Boozer, but I ain't trying to say shit. It's just... Cut? That's who I am. I've done a lot of stupid shit in my life, but joining the MC, well... Let's just say that it's one of the few things that I don't regret.
Ricky, what are we doing here? I've seen the Nero death trains before and hordes.
I know. Not like this.
What the fuck?
Watch. I've come out here a few times to see them. They stay in those old machine buildings and they come out every night like someone's ringing a dinner bell, right? When it's morning, they go back inside and what? Hibernate?
You mean you never went down there to see?
Uh-huh. No. One time I got way too close, and a dozen of them started chasing me. It's like poking a hornet's nest. Come on, let's get out of here. It's getting dark.
Okay. Okay, anyway, the other day... I saw something you won't believe.
Really? You want to talk? All right, let's hear it. Wait, let me guess. You saw a Nero helicopter.
Wait, how did you know about that?
They've been spotted a few times all over Lost Lake.
Shit.
Why do you care? It's not like they're here to help us. From the sound of it, they shoot on sight.
I don't care.
Oh, sounded like you did.
Hey, where the hell have you been all day?
Nice to see you too.
Yeah, well, Sizzle said you and Deacon took off, and I was worried.
Addie, I'm tired, okay?
Oh, that's rich.
Hey, Deke, thank you.
Yeah, well, just let me know when you're ready to tackle that transformer. I'll be around.
Sure.
It's bullshit.
What is your problem?
No, what is your problem?
I just said, I'm tired. That's it.
Okay. I'm sorry. Like I said, I was worried. It's not like you to just take off without talking to me.
Okay.
So that's it?
Duty. Yeah, well, it's too bad, huh? Schizo. Oh, schizo. Speaking of schizo, I wonder what the hell he did all day. It doesn't look too bad. That's it.
Ricky, you there? I'm gonna be gone for a while. I'm gonna need you to cover for me. Schizo's gonna wonder why I'm not out on marsh duty or whatever the hell.
Hey, Dick. What's up?
Boozer's, hell. He's depressed or something. Talk to Addy. I think I know a way to cheer him up.
So what are you gonna do?
I thought I'd maybe head to O'Leary Mountain, get his bike, and bring it back.
That's a long way to go on foot.
Figure something out. Are you gonna cover for me or what?
Yeah.
Thanks, Ricky. Peeking out.
O'Brien, I'm at one of your beacons, the one near Camp Creek. There's nothing here.
Hold on. Okay. A field op should be there any minute. You know the drill. O'Brien out.
Yeah, I know the drill. Try not to get my ass shot off while being your goddamn peeping Tom. St. John out.
You guys don't know how much I hate these missions.
Yeah, so what was that all about? I mean, last time we talked, it sounded like you were pissing your hazmat suit.
It's nothing. Like I told you, there are people above me who don't want us to know going on. I got too close, I almost got caught.
You know what? I don't give a shit. All I want from you is information on Sarah.
Whitaker, I've got someone working on it. It's gonna take time. I guess you have to be patient. This research group isn't part of my unit, so I can't track them after this op. I need you to...
Place a tracker on their chopper. Yeah, I get it. Oh, and you want me to spy on the guy wearing the white spacesuit. Yeah, anything else?
Yeah, try not to get your ass shot off. Your, comm was still open before. Don't think of it as, like, me getting Tom, or, like, the opposition research. Brian out. Anyone else hear this?
You call it.
Field note 2068. Another subject exhibiting the morphology of stage 2 infection. Tendons in the hands and fingers are less constricted, fingernails less claw-like, as if recently chewed. Additionally, the subject is wearing jewelry and clothing less tattered and worn than...
Hey, sorry. Couldn't help overhearing.
Ah, gun-toting biology major.
Yeah, something like that. So, it's wearing jewelry. What's the significance of that?
These things have been out here for 2 years, scratching and clawing at us and each other.
Yeah.
Try putting a gold watch on a baboon for 2 years. Set it loose in the wild and see what happens to it.
Okay, I get your point.
This watch looks new.
Really? So?
So, that means this subject has either been taken care of it, or has recently...
Recently put it on? Shit, I thought they were all, you know...
Bad shit crazy? Yeah, they are, but just as some late-stage dementia patients could still have moments of lucidity, victims of stage 2 virus infections seem to retain some level of vestigial memory.
Oh, shit.
No shit. Look at its clothes.
They're
almost clean, right? I mean, not clean, but most freaks are so caked with shit and piss.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, well, again, put a pair of pants on a baboon for 2 years.
Jesus.
You ever wonder why there's so many more freaks in areas where people used to live?
Thought about it. Yeah, I guess they do.
Yeah. We think there might still be something buried deep in their massively deformed heads that remembers what they once were.
Jesus, you don't think they're aware of it.
No. We've done the CT scans. They might as well be brain dead, in human terms.
What's that mean?
Well, what it means is that some freaks get up in the morning, they put on their favorite gold watch, they kiss their wife goodbye, and then they head out the door for a fun day of meeting us.
What?
And shitting themselves. Why the hell are these guys wasting their time with this shit? Hope you got all that up running. Okay, now I just gotta get the hell out of here.
Wonder how long this will take. Shouldn't be too long.
O'Brien, you there? O'Brien!
Hold on. Yeah, I'm here.
I planted your tracking device and I got your data.
The researcher, were they male or female?
What? Why?
Was it a man or a woman?
It was a woman and...
Send some men to go out and get him.
Yeah, he's a lot more cooperative all of a sudden. Evidently, our guys got to him just before a swarm. They offered to leave him where he was if he didn't tell them where the seats were.
So good. Yeah, I really would have just left him there to rot.
Yeah, you know what Iron Mike would say about that?
Yeah, I know.
See you, Ricky.
Campbell and Reed aren't allowed to tell their side.
Hey, we got folks that'll be there, speaking on their behalf. And we got witnesses. It's the way we do things, Deke.
Why don't you give them to me for 5 minutes? You'll have a confession.
Thanks. We got it covered. Iron Mike out.
Taught English.
Let me get the gate. College.
Are you there?
Yeah.
Doing, brother?
As always, still out there chasing choppers.
Yeah.
Figured out what the hell got up to yet.
Not a clue.
What O'Brien told me seems legit. Nero's out here, or they're running field missions, studying the freaks. No idea why.
Hey, I gotta get going. Schizo stopped by and said I'd be shoveling shit all day.
Tell Schizo to eat shit.
Yeah, I'll pass that along. Later.
Freak, burn!
Could make something out of this.
Off the tank.
Here we go. Good.
That's right, I gotta finish burning out these nests.
Don't worry, fellas, I'll be back later. Finish burning you out.
Almost out.
Hey, I brought you something.
Wait, what the fuck? You went up and got my bike?
Well, I didn't want Cope getting it, parting it out.
Jesus, Dick.
Hey, I mean, I mostly did it, you know, in case I need parts. It's not like your gimp ass is gonna need them.
Shit. Thanks, brother. That's the one thing I miss. Riding on the open road.
Just wanted me to tell you that she paid some men to go get your bike and bring it back. It's over at the mechanic shop.
Oh, wait, what?
You're welcome, Deke. Ricky out.
Here for your bike?
I don't even know where to start with this thing.
No idea.
I was in my classroom once.
Let me get the gate.
Sorry.
John. This is Mark Copeland at Deacon St. John.
Hey, Cope. What's up?
Just checking in. A couple of my men were up to the top of O'Leary Mountain the other day. Said they found a safe house set up in an old Forest Service watchtower.
Is that right?
Yes, sir. That's what I'm told. They said it was abandoned, but funny thing. Whoever lived there left behind a bike. Good shape, too, by the sound of it.
Really?
Indeed. That's not the funny thing. The funny thing is they went back up there today to pick it up, but the bike was gone. Now, ain't that a head-scratcher?
Look, totally fascinating, but,
Now, hold on. Here's the fascinating part. They swear that old bike, well, looked a lot like the one Boozer used to ride.
Okay, so let me get this straight, Cope. You guys went up to O'Leary Mountain. You found what you thought was Boozer's bike. And the first thing you thought of was, hey, why don't we just go back and steal it?
Salvage, dude. Salvage. But no, that was my second thought. My first was, whatever happened to old Boozer? Manny says he hasn't seen him around for some time.
I don't know, Cope. Next time I see him, I'll let him know how much you miss him. St. John out.
Deacon, you there?
Yeah, Addie, what's up?
Can you stop by the infirmary when you get a chance?
Anything wrong?
No, I just need to talk to you.
Yeah, okay.
God damn it.
Never did finish burning out this nesting zone. I'll come back later and finish burning out these nests.
Thank you.
finish burning out this infestation zone.
So, I took Boozer into the Lost Lake camp, and I know, I told you I was never going back there with Iron Mike threatening to break my neck and all, but didn't have a choice. See, Boozer was gonna die, and he still didn't want to go. Hell, I didn't want to go, but like I said, didn't have a choice. Neither of us did, so it didn't matter. He lost the arm anyway. Stuck. I mean, we're stuck. Goddamn Schizo. You know, I can't remember if I told you about this clown, but he's the kind of asshole that's glad all this shit went down. He says he was gangbanging in Sacramento, Fresno. I don't remember, but he says he's not from around here, and he's not. Claims he was dealing drugs and guns from California, Oregon, and then everything went to hell. And you know what? I think he's full of shit. To me, he kind of looks like a frat boy, like he was on the lacrosse team peddling sodas at a mini mart. Or no, man, he would have had a cushy job at his old man's accounting firm, making copies and getting everyone their morning coffee. You know, making more in a day than I've ever made in a week. You know, it's this game that Boozer and I used to play before we rode out of Lost Lake for good. We used to call it "Who You Were." You know, we'd look at someone, we'd try to guess who they were before the shit went down. You know, I met a few drug addicts, a lot of ex-cons, no accountants. So, that makes sense, if you think about it. First couple of weeks after the shit went down, Jesus, that was a freak show. There's no way some accountant or pencil pusher lived through that shit, so I don't know, maybe it's because I was telling the truth. I'm not sorry that you missed it. Anyway, Boozer and I wanted to head north and get away from all this shit, but that ain't happening anytime soon, or happening ever. Hey, look on the bright side. Looks like you're stuck with me. Okay, I'll stop by later. See you. That's it. This.
That's my fault. I meant to switch to the Molotov.
Okay, here we go. Come on, come on, come on.
God damn it.
Hey, someone's at the gate. Open the gate.
Hey, Deacon, you got a second? How's William? I haven't seen him lately.
How's Boozer? How the hell are any of us? He's surviving.
Yeah, well, then he's doing better than most.
Yeah.
Listen, you need to keep an eye on him.
What do you mean?
Well, losing an arm is a big adjustment. He's given up the life he had.
Wasn't much of a life, Addy.
You're his friend. The only one he's got.
Thank you.
Boozer's fine. He'll live anyway.
I feel bad for Boozer for losing an arm and stuff, but as soon as we find some gas, that's gonna be the end of today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed as much as I did. Yeah, we just need to find it. So it looks like before we end today's video, I see that we have so much more for this game than expected. So I don't know. The sad thing is, I don't want to say do a whole walkthrough because how long this game is. If you get this video up to 10 likes, then I'll continue. If not, yeah. But yeah, I'm gonna go find some gas. Hope you guys enjoyed. Peace.